Hey guys, Daniel here again with another tutorial for you, this time on a question that I received from one of my viewers about doing a macro with some extra code in there. So let's have a look at this. Thanks to Mary Page for your question and suggestion on the video. You asked if I can make a video to show how to create a macro using F2 as the hotkey and the macro to advance to the next asterisk symbol. Hopefully I'm understanding this correctly. So I have templates that I fill in certain spaces throughout the templates which have an asterisk symbol where the next entry needs to be made, so I want to be able to open my template and use the F2 key to advance your cursor to the next asterisk symbol in the document. I'm stuck on how to get the recording of the advancement of the cursor to the asterisk. So thanks for your question. Now that I'm reading this after beginning to record this, I'm thinking maybe you're asking just to see that the F2 key will only advance to the next asterisk symbol or to do some other command and then do that. I think it's better to have it all in one command. So if you're going to be doing the same thing in each one, but I can show you both in here. It's a two-step process where you're going in to record a macro, and then the second part is to edit the macro. So I'm going to show you exactly how to do this coming right up. All right, so let's have a look at my screen here and I'll show you how to do this. So I did up a mock document just to kind of show what I think that Pam might be looking at. So what we want to do is, in the beginning of this document, we're going to go, so I went under view because we're at the home screen. I'm already under view macros and record a macro. So I believe you already know how to initiate doing a macro. So we're going to do, I'll call this F2 next. So it's going to be using the F2 key to run to the next asterisk symbol. So it's going to be a keyboard command. And I will press F2 to assign it to the F2 key and save changes in. I want to do it only for this document. I don't want to do it for the global template. So we'll hit assign and close, and now it's recording. So at this point we don't need to add anything. If you just want to add the asterisk symbol or to find the next asterisk symbol, we can just stop the recording now. But if you wanted to add something else first, all right, so I put in some text there. Maybe you want to hold it or just part of it, and then we'll stop recording. So we've got the first part of our macro done. So when we hit F2, all it's going to do at this point, I'll just do a new line here and hit F2, it puts in the string. Of course it's carrying from where it left off. That is not what I want it to do, so I'm going to just make this a little bit more realistic. All right, F2, there. So it's not keeping my underline on here for some reason, so I didn't record that part, but that's not what this tutorial's about. So we're going to move forward, and under view, macros, view macros. Now I don't see my macro in here. I'll search global. So I got the macro. I want to edit. Now we can see the part of the macro where it typed in the text that we have, and then it was doing some bolding, italic, underline, and it screwed up in here somewhere. So, but rather than deal with that or redoing it, that's kind of irrelevant to what we're doing. So what we want now is to add, I'm just gonna make this smaller here. So we're gonna add the other code. So where we add the code will make a difference. If we want to do it at the beginning of the code, so it will search for the asterisk first and then run the script, typing in the text, bolding, italic, all that stuff. Or do we run the adding of the text first and then search for the next asterisk symbol? In which case you would add it after the end if. So we can try both. So on a quick Google search, I was able to get the command for that. So it's selection.find.execute, and then we have a space in there, and then it's find text colon equals quote star quote. So it's going to put in that asterisk symbol, or I'm sorry, it's going to find that asterisk symbol. Then it will type in this text. So if we close out of this edit, I'm going to delete what I had there. So now if I hit F2, it jumped down here, it found the asterisk symbol, and it inserted that. So the next one would jump down below line 5 and then line 8. So I'll just hit F2 right from here, and it did that one correctly, and then I'll hit it again, and it did that perfectly. So it's searching for the next symbol, and then it's doing that. So I'm going to undo . All right, so let's go back and view the macro, edit. So here's the command that we added, and I'll put that in the comments below for you so you can just copy and paste that. But I'm gonna cut that out of there, and I think, now we'll have to test that, we'll put it right here just below the end sub, because this is part of this sub here. So now it's gonna type in, when I hit F2, it should put in the text right here where my cursor is now above line 1, and then go down to the asterisk symbol. So let's try it. And it did, it inserted that line right there, and now it found and highlighted the next asterisk symbol. So if I hit F2 again, it should replace that symbol with the text under line 3 and then jump to the one under line 5. And it did perfectly. So obviously this is working great. So it depends if you want it to find the symbol first and then insert it, or insert the text and then find the symbol. If you didn't want it to do anything except just find the text, and we go in here and edit this, and we can delete all of this. So really this whole subroutine is just finding the symbol. So let's back out of all this. So if I hit F2, it found the first asterisk symbol. It hasn't typed anything yet. So if I hit F2 again, it found the one under 5, and again the one under 8. So this is working perfectly now as well, by simply finding the symbol, and it's not doing anything. It's available for you to now. There you go. Hopefully that is what you were looking for. I gave you a few variations of what you can do searching before or after, as well as just searching and not doing anything but search for the next symbol. and that ties it into the F2 key on the keyboard. You can do that with any key that you want. That's it for this tutorial. Please give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for more videos. All right, thanks guys. Bye for now.